मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर हैविंग केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल एंड नॉन मेटल, नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ बॉन्ड. व्हाट हैपन व्हेन दीज मेटल एंड नॉन मेटल रिएक्ट विथ वन अनदर एंड हाउ दे डू रिएक्ट विथ वन अनदर एंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ बॉन्ड दे आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म एंड एक्चुअली व्हाई दे आर गोइंग टू रिएक्ट विथ वन अनदर. दीज ऑल आर द क्वेश्चन दैट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू because these are the basis of chemistry that why they any of the element is going to combine. So here first we will discuss about the metals and non-metals. As we know that metals are what? Metals are called to be as electropositive element because most of the element which is present in our periodic table, like here you people are knowing till 30 element. So we have lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, these all are taken as a metal. Okay, and when we see the electronic configuration of metal, it is found that all metal have a few more electron on their outermost shell. It means if we will be seeing the electronic configuration of sodium, it is atomic number of sodium is 11, and when we will see the electronic configuration, it is 281. So on the basis of electronic configuration to get noble gas configuration. What do you mean by noble gases? So actually these noble gases are also called to be as inert gas. These are the element whose valence electron and whose configuration is stable, is complete. That's why all the element want to achieve noble gas configuration and they want to be like noble gases. That's why to attain noble gas configuration, all the elements either they lose their electron or they gain electron to complete their octet. So while losing or while gaining the electron, they are going to make a bond with one another. So this type of bond, when it is formed by the loss or gain of electron, it is called to be an ionic bond. And the compound which is going to form is called to be an ionic compound. Okay, so here whenever a metal and non-metal they are going to form, they are going to combine, they form ionic bond. But when two non-metals are going to combine, because non-metals are called the acceptor of the electron, non-metal always having lack of electron, one or two or three number of electron they are needed to complete its octet. That's why non-metal always try to grab the electron from other element. Okay, so non-metal are not going to give electron to anyone in case when metal and non-metal is going to combine. So if there is combination takes place between two non-metals, so both the non-metal are going to share their electron, and whatever the bond that is going to form by the sharing of electron is called to be as covalent bond, and the compound is called to be as covalent compound. For about the covalent compound we will discuss in chapter 4, because fourth chapter is fully based on the compounds that is made up of carbon, and carbon is going to form covalent bond only. So this chapter is very important and it is fully based on covalent compound. Here we will be discussing only about the ionic compound. And how does this ionic compound form? It is formed by the combination of metals and non-metal. Now let's have a look on the electronic configuration of noble gases. Like the element which is present at the very right of the periodic table, that is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon, these are called to be as the noble gases and inert gases. They are called as inert gas because they are present in the form of gas in very trace amount in our atmosphere, and they never, means most of the time they do not take part in the reaction. That's why they are called to be as inert gas. Inertness means they are not reactive, okay, inactive gases. So that's why it is called as inert gas. Why it do not shows reaction? Because of the complete octet. See, look at the electronic configuration. Atomic number of helium is what? It is 2. So when we will do the electronic configuration, we know that we have 4 shell that you have studied till this class, that is K, L, M and L. Okay, so K shell, it has the ability to accommodate 2 electron only. L shell, it has the ability to have 8 electron. M shell can have 18 electron and N shell can have 32 electron. But whenever we are talking about the outermost shell, okay, outermost shell should always be have only 8 electron. It should never be more than 8 electron, because outermost shell is the only shell which is going to take part in the reaction. Or if it will be having more than 8 electron in its outermost shell, so they are not going to make bond with anyone and they cannot participate in the reaction. That's why the configuration will be wrong. Okay, so when we see the electronic configuration of these, see, helium, it has atomic number 2. So in case shell of helium, it has 2 electrons. That is complete. For neon, it has atomic number 10. And in its shell, that is in case shell, it has 2 electrons. And its L shell, it has 8 electrons. That is also complete. Again, we have argon. For argon, it is atomic number of argon is 18. And electronic configuration of this one is 288. Students, don't get confused that M is having the ability to accommodate 18. Yes, it is correct. But it can have, if it is having 8 electron in its shell, then it is taken as the stable form. Because either it should have 8 electron or it should have 18 electron. If it is having any more element than electron, then it has to shift in on the another shell. Okay. Next we have krypton. Atomic number of krypton is 36 and the electronic configuration of this one is 2, 8, 18 and 8. Again, because of the because as I already explained you that the outermost shell should have 8 electron, and if it has 8 electron, then it is considered as the stable form. So that's why these all noble gases are the stable form of element. That's why they are quite stable in nature, and that's why they do not take part in the chemical reaction. Okay, because they do not need anything. If your stomach is already full, at that time you are not going to ask for food. But if your stomach is empty, then only at that time you are searching for something to eat, isn't it? So here already it is stable, that's why it do not need anything else for completing its octet. But if you will be seeing the electronic configuration of metal and non-metal, they are having lacking of electron. Either they are having more number of electron or they are having less number of electron. So to be like noble gases, or to attain the noble gas configuration, they are either going to gain electron or they are either going to lose electron. First we will talk about metals. See, here we have sodium. Sodium is a metal. Atomic number of sodium is what? 11. It is Z is equal to 11 is given because Z represent atomic number. And Na, it is a symbol of sodium. Okay. Atomic number of sodium is what? It is 11. And when we will have the electronic configuration of this one, it is 281. Okay. Next we have magnesium. It has atomic number 12 and the electronic configuration is 282. For aluminium, it is 283. For potassium, it is 2881. And calcium, it is 2882. It means that to attain the noble gas configuration, in the outermost shell, they should have 8 electron, isn't it? Now we are talking only about the metal. So look at the metal only. Don't look at non-metals. Here we are talking only about metal. So to attain noble gas configuration, the outermost shell should have 8 electron. So it would be very difficult for the sodium to gain 7 electron from anywhere else. And that's why sodium is trying to lose its 1 electron, to give 1 electron to anyone which is needed. The one which need 1 electron. Okay. So that's why sodium is going to combine with what? Either sodium is going to combine with chlorine or it is going to combine with fluorine, because chlorine and fluorine are the element which need only 1 electron to complete its octet. Isn't it? So the bond is going to form between sodium and chlorine, and the compound is called to be a sodium chloride. So because all the metal, they are having either 1 or 2 or 3 electron in its outermost shell. So to complete its octet, it need 8 electron, but it would be very difficult for the sodium to take 7 electron from anyone, for magnesium to take 6 electron from anyone, and for aluminium to ask for 5 electron from anyone. That's why they simply try to give their electron to anyone which is needed. But if we will be talking about non-metals, look at the electronic configuration. Non-metal like nitrogen, atomic number of nitrogen is 7. Okay, and the electronic configuration of this one is 2 and 5. It means nitrogen need 3 more electron to become stable, because outermost shell should have what? It should have 8 electron, and it need 3 electron. Oxygen, it need 2 electron. Fluorine, it need only 1 electron. So because they need less number of electron to complete its octet, that's why they are trying to take electron from someone. By giving 5 electron or by giving 6 electron or 7 electron, it will be difficult. That's why they are trying to take 1, 2 or 3 electron from anyone to complete its octet. That's why metal and non-metal is going to make bond with each other by the loss or gain of electron. And here by the loss or gain of electron, whenever the bond is formed, the bond is called to be as ionic or electrovalent bond. It is called as ionic bond because here the formation of ion takes place. Na positive and Cl negative is going to form. So because of the formation of ions takes place, that's why it is called to be as ionic bond. Okay. So, bond formation between atoms of metal and non-metal. Here, as we already have discussed, that metal is going to lose their electron or give their electron to anyone which is needed, and non-metal is going to accept the electron from the other element or from the metal. Okay. And after making a bond, when they combine with one another, they have the equal number of proton and neutron. At that time they become neutral, means not at that time they become neutral, earlier when we are talking about the element, like if we are having sodium with atomic number 11, at that time, because all the atom they are having same number of electron and proton present on that, it has sodium has 11 proton, 11 electron, but here sodium is going to give one electron to someone else, that's why here the number of electron decreases. It means now it has 10 electron and 11 proton. That's why sodium is going to have one positive charge, because of the more number of proton present. Okay. But if we are talking about chlorine, because chlorine is going to gain one electron, isn't it? So atomic number of chlorine is what? Atomic number of chlorine is 17. It means chlorine has 17 proton and 17 electron, but by the gain of one electron, here the number of electron will become increases and it will become 18. Okay, so because of the more number of electron, it is going to show one anion, that is negative charge. Okay, so because of this, oppositely charged ions come closer to each other and formation of bond takes place. So these are called to be as electrovalent bond. Okay. And here it can be defined as the force of attraction which hold oppositely charged ions together is called to be as electrostatic or ionic bond. So here we have many more example of this bond, like sodium chloride. Look at the structure. This is the very common example, sodium chloride. Here we have sodium with atomic number 11, 281, and chlorine with 287. Sodium is going to give one electron to chlorine. That's why here arrow is shown, because complete transfer is going to take place. Whenever we are going to make a bond in which sharing is there, so there will be no arrow. But here, because sodium is going to give its electron to chlorine, that's why here we are having arrow. Always try to put this arrow, because it shows that complete transfer of electron. Okay, so because of this complete transfer of electron, bonding is going to take place. So this bonding is called as ionic bond, and the compound is called to be as ionic compound. Here we are having many more examples. See, calcium fluoride. Calcium, it is having two electrons in its outermost shell. We know that whatever the number of electron present in the outermost shell, this only we have to represent. Okay, because inner one is not going to take part in the reaction. So these two electrons you have to show in case of calcium, and fluorine, it has seven electrons in its outermost shell. So seven dot you have to represent, because here calcium is going to combine with two fluorine, because one fluorine need only one electron, but calcium has to lose two electrons. Okay, if calcium is going to give one electron to one fluorine, fluorine will become stable. But what about the calcium? Calcium has to give two of its electron to gain the noble gas configuration. That's why calcium is going to give two electron to two different fluorine, and the compound that is formed is called to be a CaF2, because here two fluorine is going to take part. Okay, here once again we are having oxygen. Sodium oxide means, here we have sodium. Sodium is able to give one electron only, because the configuration of this one is 281. It means it has only one electron in its outermost shell. But if we will talk about the oxygen, oxygen need two more electrons, because oxygen has six electrons in its outermost shell. And to gain the stability, oxygen need two more electrons. But sodium is able to give only one. That's why oxygen is going to combine with two sodium, because one is given by one sodium and another one is given by another sodium. Finally, both the sodium is going to stable and oxygen is also stable by taking the two electrons from two sodium. And the compound which is formed is called to be as Na2O, because here two sodium is going to take part. Okay, so these are called as formation of ionic compound. I hope you understood how the ionic compound is going to form, and this type of bond where the complete transfer of electron takes place and the metal is going to have positive charge, that is cation, and non-metal is going to have negative, that is anion. So because of the formation of ion, it is called to be as ionic bond. Now let's have few of the characteristics of ionic bond. Metal atom always lose their valence electron to form positive ion, that is cation. Yes, non metal always going to gain electron to form negative ion, that is anion. Yes, this also we have discussed. The number of positive charge on the metal ion is equal to the number of electron lost by them. It means whatever the number of electron they are going to lose, same number of electron, same number of charges they are going to have. Like sodium is going to lose one electron, that's why sodium is going to have one positive charge. Calcium, see here, calcium lose two electron because calcium it is having two electron in its outermost shell, so both are lost by the calcium, that's why calcium is having two positive charge. Here same, magnesium is also going to have two positive charge because magnesium is also going to lose two electron, so magnesium will also be have two positive charge. Aluminium electronic configuration of aluminium is 2, 8, 3, so aluminium is going to lose three of its electron, that's why aluminium is having three positive charge. It means the number of charges is depends on the number of electron that they are going to lose. The number of negative charge on a non-metal ion is equal to the number of electron gained by them. Yes, it is also correct that oxygen is going to take two electron for completing its octet. See here, oxygen, they are taking two electron, that's why oxygen will have two negative charge, isn't it? But if we are talking about fluorine, fluorine is going to take only one electron from one calcium. Another electron is given to another fluorine, means each fluorine is getting only one electron from the calcium. Because they are going to gain only one electron, that's why gain of electron, it means negative charge is going to form. Because they are taking only one electron, that's why fluorine will be having one negative charge, but oxygen will be having two negative charge because oxygen is taking two electron. Okay. So number of charges is depend on the number of electron that is gained. So ion formed have generally the electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas elements. Whenever the ion is going to form, whatever the atom is either gain or lose the electron, they are going to acquire the noble gas configuration, that is the nearest noble gas configuration. If we are talking about oxygen, so oxygen, the nearest noble gas is what? Neon. So they are going to get the noble gas configuration of neon. If we will be talking about hydrogen, so hydrogen is going to get the noble gas configuration of helium. Okay, so they are going to acquire the noble gas configuration which is present near to them. Next, the ionic bond result from the attraction between oppositely charged ion. Whenever this type of ionic bond is formed, it is because of the difference in charges, means because of the presence of opposite charge, positive and negative charge takes place. And due to the formation of difference in the charges, the bond which is formed is called to be as ionic bond. These are the some characteristics. Now let's have the properties of ionic compound. As we know, here the cation and anion which have strong electrostatic force of attraction. So these ions influence the property of these compound. What are the property which is influenced by the because of this ions that we will be discussing. First is the physical state. Okay, means ionic compound are generally solid which are in the form of crystal. In these crystal, ion have strong attractive force because ionic compounds are generally hard. Mostly whenever we are talking about the existence of ionic compound mostly exists in the form of what? It exists in the form of solid. Why? Because of the presence of strong bond. And we know strong bond is present in between the solid only, because gases, they have very weak bond. That's why gases can intermix with one another very easily. The bond can be break very easily. But if we will be talking about the ionic compound, they are always present in the form of solid in crystal form. Okay. And these are arranged itself in a three dimension, that is called to be as crystal lattice. These arrangement, here these arrangement you will be studying in higher classes. But here you have to see whenever they are arranging, means one chlorine, one sodium, one chlorine, one sodium, they are arranging itself like that. So this arrangement, this regular three dimension arrangement of ion in the space is called to be as crystal lattice. Okay. So physical state of ionic compound will always be solid. Next is melting point and boiling point, because we know that these are in the solid form. Solid means they have very strong force of attraction between them. In case of solid, the molecules are closely packed with one another. These things you are knowing because in class 9th we have seen the structure of solid, liquid and gas. In case of solid, molecules are very closely packed with one another. So because of these, they cannot move from one place to another place. They are that much strongly, they are, means arrangement of this one is that much strong. That's why to break the bond, it would be very difficult to break the bond which is present between the molecules of the ionic compound. That's why here the melting point and boiling point of this one is very high. Okay. See here the melting point and boiling point is of different ionic compound is given. If you want, kindly please go through that. Let's have another property, that is solubility. Ionic compound, what are the solubility? Solubility means dissolution on water. Here, because we know that water is taken as a universal solvent. So if we are talking about the solution, whether they are they are able to dissolve in the water or not. So yes, because water is also ionic compound, that's why it has the ability to dissolve in the water. Because water is also ionic. Water is also formed because of the positive and negative charge. Why? Because hydrogen, though hydrogen and oxygen, they both are the non-metal. They both are having the covalent bond. Then also oxygen being the second most electronegative element, oxygen have the ability to attract the electron from hydrogen, and that's because of that only oxygen will be having partial negative charge on that. Okay, so because of the presence of partial negative and partial positive, they are also seems to be little bit ionic. That's why this water have the ability to dissolve almost all the ionic compound present. Okay. Electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity means whether these ionic compounds are able to conduct electricity or not. So if we will be talking about, we know that these ionic compounds are present in the solid form. So whenever they are present in the solid form, it do not have their ions, because all the ions are in the bonded form. So at that time, they are not able to conduct electricity whenever they are in the bonded form. But all the ionic compounds, they are the good conductor of heat and electricity only when they are present in the molten form or in the solution form. Molten form means melted form. Whenever we are going to dissolve this one in the melted form, they are acquiring their charges, means positive and negative charge, they come into the existence. At that time, they are able to conduct electricity, because we know that for the conduction of electricity, ions or free electrons should be present. But here, whenever these are present in the form of solid, we know that movement cannot be takes place. So whenever ionic compound are present in the form of solid, they are not the conductor of electricity. But as we dissolve it into the water, or as it is present in the molten form, they are taken as the good conductor of electricity because of the presence of ions on that. Okay. See here, one question is also given, that in the formation of compound between A and B, A loses 2 electrons and B is going to gain 1 electron. So what is the nature of bond? Nature of bond is what? Ionic bond, because the bond is formed by the loss or gain of electron. Second, suggest the formula of the compound formed by A and B. So A is going to lose 2 electrons. So A is having 2 positive charge, B is going to gain 1 electron. So B will be having what? B will be having 1 negative charge. It means 1 negative charge, that is halogen. So any of the halogen you can take, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. And 2 positive charge, it means magnesium, calcium, anything you can take. So it would be CaF or MgCl2, anything you can take. Okay. Name also you have to write. Common salt conduct electricity only in the molten state. Why it is asked? See, common salt, that is NaCl, so it is asked why it is able to conduct electricity in the molten state only, but not in the solid state. So because, as I tell you, whenever they are present in the solid state, they are all the ions are not present in their bonded form. Okay, so whenever, means all are present in the bonded form, the ions are not free to move. That's why it do not conduct electricity. But as they come into the molten form, they acquire their charges, and at that time they are able to conduct electricity. Okay, so students, for today we have this much only. Rest of the thing we will discuss in the next class. If you will be getting any doubt, then please contact me. Thank you so much. Sanaya.